How to add sign up form in WordPress. Hey guys, it's me Rana back with another video, and today's video I'm gonna show you how you can add subscribe form or sign up form in your WordPress website. So guys, I highly recommend you to have this form on your website because this form can be beneficial for your business. Let me tell you what I mean by that. For instance, if you are doing email marketing, this form can help you to collect emails. Plus, this form gonna help you to interact with your audience, and this will engage more people to your website. So guys, let me show you how you can add this form, and let's get started. And I'm gonna go to my computer screen and I'm gonna show you how you can add this form on your website. So let's get started. If you're new to the channel, make sure to subscribe, or you can turn on notification by clicking this notification bell icon, and you won't miss my new uploads. And also you can leave a like if you've been enjoying these videos. So guys, now let's just take a look at the subscribe form on my website. So guys, this is the form that we are going to create in this video. This sign up form appears in a different style in a different website because this form has ability to blend with the theme. Alright guys, let me show you how you can add subscribe form or sign up form on your website. So this is a demo website, and I'm gonna add the subscribe form in the footer section of this website because my case I don't have the right side widget section, because in the home page I have only this type of design. I have only option to add widget on the footer. So I'm gonna add in the footer section that subscribe form. To do that, I'm gonna go to the dashboard of WordPress. First of all, let's go to the plugins, click on add new. Now come over here and search for MailChimp for WordPress and install this plugin. Click on install now and then click on activate. After installing this plugin, you can see this plugin in the left side of the dashboard. Now click on MailChimp. So you can see we need to add the API key right here in order to connect this plugin into MailChimp account. To get the API key, click on this link, get your API key here. It will take you to the login page of MailChimp. If you have account, you can log in. If you don't have account, you can create account by clicking on create an account button. Here you need to type your email and type your username and type your password, and then click on get started. Now you will receive a verification email to activate this account. Let's close this tab. Let's go to your email. Let's refresh. And you can see now we have this email from MailChimp. Now click on activate account. Now click on I'm not robot. Now complete this captcha. Now type your first name and then your last name, and then click on continue. Now what is the name of your business? I'm gonna type blog test. You can name whatever you like. Now type your website URL here, then click on continue. Now type your address, then click on continue. Does your business sell anything online? No. Then click on continue. You can connect your social account with MailChimp if you like. Otherwise, click on continue. You can subscribe to the newsletter of MailChimp if you like. This is a totally optional. I'm gonna click on let's go. Maybe later. So guys, this is the dashboard of MailChimp. So here, let's click on this drop down button alongside your profile. Click on profile. Now click on this drop down button alongside extras and click on API keys. Scroll down and you can see we don't have any API key. To create an API key, click on create a key. Now scroll down. You can see we have this API key. Now select this whole API key by pressing Ctrl A to select all. Right click, copy. Let's go to the dashboard and paste your API key right here. And then click on save changes. And you can see the status says connected. And you can see we have one list here. If you do not have any list here, your MailChimp subscribe form does not work. In order to check your MailChimp list, go back to your MailChimp account, click on list, and here you can see we have this
list. This list helps us to collect the email when people subscribe to our website newsletter. So if you do not see any list over here, then make sure create a new list by clicking the create a list and then click on create a list. Since I already have a list, I'm not gonna do this again. Let's go back to your MailChimp and let's click on form. So here, what is the name of this form? So I'm gonna type subscribe and I'm gonna add this form into this list and click on add form. So guys, you can see this is a preview of your subscribe form or sign up form. Now you can see we only have this email, but I also like to add first name and last name into this sign up form. In order to add first name and a last name, come over here, press enter and go to the first row and then click on first name. I'm gonna copy this and paste in placeholder and check this box. This field is required and click on add form. And next I'm gonna add the last name. I'm gonna copy this, control C and control V, and I'm gonna check this box also, click on add form, and you can see now we have first name, last name and email. You can add as many as you like, but for now I think this is sufficient. Once you've done that, scroll down and click on save changes. Now let's go to the message. Here you can type any message you like to show your visitor, your subscriber. Go to the settings, make sure you check this list that you created on your MailChimp account. If you like to redirect your visitor, your subscriber to another page, you can add that page URL right here and then click on save changes. Appearance. So everything is done. Now click on save changes. Now go back to your website and then click on customize. Now scroll down. Now I'm going to add the subscribe form widget in the footer section. Let's go to the widget. Click on the footer widget area 1. Click on add widget. Now I'm gonna find the MailChimp sign up form. So select the form, click done, drag this to the top. So guys, you can see this is a subscribe form or sign up form widget for your website. Once you've done that, click on publish. So guys, I added this sign up form in the footer section. You can add anywhere in your website if your website has option to add widget on different section. Alright guys, that's the end of this video guys. I hope you like this video. If you learn something from this video, please hit the like button, and if you have any question regarding this video, you can ask me in the comment section below. And of course, if you're new here, consider subscribing because I drop a new video every single week on this channel. So that being said, goodbye and see you next time.